Very good morning to both the classes. So we are having plus 1B as well as plus 1C in the class. And can I have attention of all the students, please? This is for you only. Clear, not for me. And we are going to start new chapter, Albert Einstein at School. I have written, firstly, I'll be introducing the characters to you. Then I'll discuss what we are going to read. It's about the theme. And then we'll start the reading, okay? So please note down. The protagonist, obviously, is Albert Einstein himself, main character. And then we have Mr. Braun. He's the history teacher. Elsa is Albert's cousin. And you can say support system of Albert Einstein in the need of the time. Vansh, please stand up from there and shift here. Yes. No, please come here. I don't want to get disturbed again and again. He's talking. See? Yuri, Albert's friend, and Dr. Ernst, he'll be coming after these characters will be introduced. So he has some role to play, but not in the beginning. It will be in the middle or the end. Fine. There will be some more characters also that I'll tell you. Now, characters are clear to you. I have already mentioned in the brackets, so that is easy for you. Now, what we're going to read in this chapter, everybody knows. If I ask you, who is Albert Einstein? Raise your hand. Whatever explanation. Yes, Vansh, right. He's a scientist. What else? In the introduction of Albert Einstein, do you know what he has invented? Which formula? Yes, now you remember he is equal to mc square. So being science students, you should know about Albert Einstein basically. But you know, when a person reaches pinnacle is the topmost position, fine, or zenith of success, the topmost point in life, that person does not reach, you know, after you can say numerous efforts, after continuous hard work, that person has reached there. So we just talk about, okay, that person has now, what do you remember? You know that he has invented E equal to mc square. You remember he's a scientist, but you do not know the background story. And, you know, I always say that your marks are not going to decide what you will become in life. Sometimes you do not get good marks. You become disheartened. And you start associating your report card or marks with the achievements you will make in the future. No. You can be a genius, but you're not scoring good marks. It doesn't mean ki padhna chhod dena. Okay? I'm saying that, yes, try to score good marks. But I'm saying that life of successful person, we should have a vent into how that person try to read success stories of the such kind of people. Then you will get inspiration. So we are going to get a vent into the life of Albert Einstein in this chapter. That what sort of schooling he had, education system. He was not, you know, he never liked history. Reason, he was not interested in cramming the facts that when, what happened. He was saying, tell me why that happened. How to stop that he was interested in. Fine, rather than when did that battle occurred, at what happened and all. Why they were fighting, that is to be taught according to Albert Einstein. So education system is the foremost theme, specifically rigid system in which you are supposed to cram the facts. Okay. Next is problems faced by students. Now you as student, raise your hand. Do not, you know, start in that way now. Start putting your aggressions out about the system. I'm just saying, there are n number of problems faced by you people. Sometimes you have not prepared homework. Some test is given to you. You are not prepared. Fine. You could not get school. So n number of problems are there. And maybe you might be having some problem at home that day. You were not well that day. So n number of problems are faced. But here, my concern is problems are like there are a lot of physical changes going on. A lot of emotional changes going on in the student's life. And most importantly, all are not confident enough to face the situation. Most of you know the answer, but you never raise hands. Lack of confidence. Fine. You see the question paper, you feel butterflies in the stomach. You get nervous. Out of nervousness, how many of you experience that you get the question paper and everything is out of your mind? See. There are students. It happens. It happens when we read the question, we know the answer, but we are not able to explain it. Sometimes we are out of words. We start thinking harder, but we are not getting ideas. So sometimes we get so nervous that out of nervousness, actually, we forget the thing. And you have prepared the topic very well. Formulas mein hota hoga bahut baar. Fine. So problems faced by students, I mean by that only. That sometimes students, out of the fear of the teacher, out of the fear of the education system, out of the expectations of their parents, they start having many psychological problems in their lives. We will see Albert Einstein faced one situation when he had nervous breakdown. What do you mean by nervous breakdown? Tell me. Anybody knows? No one. Galat jawab ho jayega, kya ho jayega? At least try to speak. So when you stop commenting that last boy. Yes, you are talking only the whole class. In between you speak, that is quite perceivable to me. Otherwise, I'll be announcing the names. It is being recorded here. So it's not your arrangement period. You have come here to learn something. Please be serious. So I was talking about what is nervous breakdown. When you become too nervous to understand that you will go to any extent. He did not like the school, rigid school system actually. So he was living in a hostel where owners of the place where he was residing, in a rented room actually, not a hostel. So the lady over there, she was very noisy. Fine. And he was not supposed to, he was having passion of playing violin also. He was not supposed to play that even. Whenever he was bugged up, he would play. Everybody has hobbies and interests, which is a kind of escapism to us. It rejuvenates us. He was not supposed to play that also. In a very small, shabby room, he was residing, already problems in the place where you are living. And when you go to a school, teachers are also, you know, scolding you like anything. And then you become a scientist like Albert Einstein. So it does not mean he never faced problems. He faced a lot of problems in his life that you can say a part of it we are going to read only, not the whole. So teacher-taught relation means relationship between a teacher and a student. What sort of relation should be there, but should not be there? That is also we are going, one of the themes of this chapter. Is it clear to all? Yes, online children, to you too? Send me your feedback accordingly. You have noted down the points. So let's start. Page number 25. Albert Einstein at School by Patrick Pringle. Albert Einstein is regarded as the greatest physicist since Newton. In the following extract from the young Einstein, the well-known, somebody pronounced it as Einstein also. Both the pronunciations are acceptable. Einstein or Einstein, fine. The well-known biographer Patrick Pringle describes the circumstances which led to Albert Einstein's expulsion from a German school. Expulsion means when he is thrown out of the school. What he has done means to that level came that he was expelled from his school. Fine, that is the real thing. He is mentioned in the it is mentioned in the biography of Albert Einstein. Clear? So he was thrown out of the German school. He was expelled. What he did, we will be reading in this. So I'm sharing the screen with you all. You can have a view. Yes. In what year, Einstein asked the history teacher, did the Russians defeat the French at Waterloo? I don't know, sir. Why don't you know? You have been told it often enough. I must have forgotten. So chapter starts with a conversation between Mr. Braun, the name is written here, you can see, history teacher, fine, and Albert Einstein. So this conversation is there. Teacher asked the question, that underline this question. You get a question on this also, what question was asked by the teacher and what was the answer given by the student. So in what year, he asked, history is all about dates and facts only. He said, I don't know. He was very honest in giving answers. He said, I don't know, sir. He said, I must have forgotten. Aap uthiye yahan se, please, it is getting disturbed. Bunch, please uthiye idhar aajao. Aap uthiye idhar aajao, please. I cannot start like that. I will not continue. Continuously, there is noise. Everybody can feel. You can sit anywhere, wherever you want to sit. So I don't know, sir. That was the answer. Why don't you know? You have been told often enough. I must have forgotten. The answer came from Albert. Did you ever try to learn? Asked Mr. Brown. Kabhi try kiya? Have you learnt it? No, sir. Albert replied with his usual unthinking honesty. So he was very, you know, honest in his approach. And he said that, no, I never tried to learn, actually. Why not? He asked. Teacher asked, why not you tried even earlier? I can't see any point. Underline, this is the viewpoint of Albert Einstein about the education system or history specifically. I can't see any point in learning dates. One can always look them up in a book. He says, whenever you want to read that what happened when, we can open a book and we can find the date and data over there. Why we are cramming and mugging it up, according to Albert. Mr. Brown was speechless for a few moments. So do you think this is nice? Yes, maybe he has a clear vision of what he likes and what he does not. But having such conversation with a teacher, that is also incorrect in a way. So teacher was very hurt at the way he answers him back. You amaze me, Einstein, he said at last. Don't you realize that one can always look most things up in books? That applies to all the facts you learn at school. He says, if you can find the dates of history in the book, then everything is written in the book. Why we are studying then? Teacher said that. Everything can be found in book, then it applies to all the subjects. Yes, sir. Rather than saying or keeping mum, sometimes situations are there, you want to speak, even you cannot, in front of the teacher specifically. He said, yes, sir. Then I suppose you don't see any point in learning facts? Frankly, sir, I don't, said Albert. Then you don't believe in education at all. A teacher is just making conclusions out of the conversation. He's saying, "So, aapko to education hi nahi pasand, that means." Oh, yes, sir, I do. I don't think learning facts is education. Underline, double underline this line. This is the whole concept of Albert Einstein. I don't think learning facts is education. Very right. You can say interpretation. He says that I do believe in education, but I do not believe that cramming the facts is education, according to me. Clear? So you should be very much clear what is the idea of education of Albert Einstein. Clear ho gaya sabko? Koi doubt to nahi hai? Page 26. In that case, said the history teacher with heavy sarcasm, sarcastic remarks, you know, when a person becomes angry in a way and he becomes sarcastic in his tone. Perhaps you will be so kind to tell the class, Einstein, your theory of education. Teacher became so angry, but he said, okay, so you do not believe in education. Mr. Einstein will come and tell us what is education now, dear students, in that way. He became very sarcastic. So he was thinking, let's see now, what does he say? And Albert flushed. Means it was like when you have a lot of emotions, it can be seen on your face. He hesitated earlier. I think, and you know, rather than keeping mum and keeping quiet, he started telling the class, what is education? He says, I think it's not facts that matter, but ideas. Underline, this is another part you can add up, idea of education according to Albert Einstein. He says, mere liye facts matter nahi karte hain, ideas. Fine. Imaginative thinking, creative ideas, that is education. I don't see the point in learning dates of battles or even which of the armies killed more men. I would be more interested in learning why those soldiers were trying to kill each other. He's right in this. So he's saying why they were fighting, that is my interest of area of interest. And I am not interested in cramming ki what happened at what year. That's enough. Mr. Brown's eyes were cold and cruel. We don't want a lecture from you, Einstein. You will stay in for an extra period today. Although I don't imagine it will do you much good. It won't do the school any good either. You are a disgrace. I don't know why you continue to come. Underline this. These are the dialogues of teacher, history teacher, Mr. Brown. He calls his student disgrace. What do you mean by disgrace here? Jisko keh dete na ki in the whole system you are not at all, you are fitting into our system. You are an misfit person. So he teacher remarks about the student. This attitude of the teacher is also not correct. Yes, student and teacher in this only part, teacher is not able to understand what student is trying to say, and student is also conveying in a wrong way. There are ways to convey your ideas rather than becoming a rebel of doing, you know, rebel is what you do opposite of what is asked to you. So he should say in a polite way, ki sir, in that way, but he was quite clear, and teacher became angry and he called him disgrace. He says he gave him punishment. What punishment given to Albert Einstein? That he will be staying to school that day for extra period. And even teacher added that that will be no use to you and no use to school also. But even then I give you punishment. It's not my wish, sir, Albert pointed out. When he says now that you should not come to school, he says it's not my wish. Means he never wanted to come to school. He mentioned that also. Then you are an ungrateful boy and ought to be ashamed of yourself. I suggest you ask your father to take you away. So teacher remarked, if you do not want to come to school, ask your father, he will take you away. Albert felt miserable when he left school that afternoon. Not that it had been a bad day. Most days were bad now. Anyway, but because he had to go back to the hateful place the next morning. He was very sad that day because of what happened in the class with Mr. Braun. And almost each day was bad enough for him. When he went back, he was thinking that again I have to come in the morning to this place where I am not at all fitting into. Means where I do not, you know, connect to the teachers. Teachers do not connect to me. So that was the situation he was facing. He says, going back to his lodgings did not cheer him up. Now, second situations. We have got to know about the situation in the school that he's not having good terms with history teacher, Mr. Braun. Secondly, now his lodgings. Lodgings are the place where he resides. Okay, jahan pe wo reh rahe. So his lodgings, his residing area, it did not cheer him up. Ab wahan jaake bhi wo khush nahi hai. Reason? His father had so little money to spare that Albert had been found a room in one of the poorest quarters of Munich. He was not a rich fellow at all. The world's famous greatest scientist was not rich. Yes, you are hearing it right. Richness and success has nothing to do. People start associating that you have to be rich if you want to be successful. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Most, if you read the success stories, you'll get to know people started with few rupees in their pockets only. And now they are having billions of businesses, fine? So I'm just saying, his father was not rich enough to spare a good room or hostel or with good facilities. He could spare a lot, you can say a bit of money. And he got a very small rented room in very bad locality. Locality was not at all good there. Then what happened over there? He did not mind the bad food. Food was also not good. Lack of comfort or even the dirt and squalor. In very dirty circumstances he was residing. But he hated the atmosphere of slum violence. So slum areas, you know, where most of the poor locality people live, where filth and garbage dumps are found. Fine, you can find mosquitoes and bees easily, stinky places. So that was the scene when he, a person who is having bad day in the schools, not liking the education system and coming back to home at least. Everybody of us, we, you know, when there is a holiday, we feel so happy. At least, okay, we will be living at home, enjoying with the family or going out and taking a change. He was not living with his parents. He was not happy at school. He was not happy at his lodgings also. See. Clear? So that was the thing. So Albert felt miserable. While going back, he did not mind the bad food and lack of comfort. But it is mentioned that he never, you know, complained that I'm living in a bad phase. I'm not getting good food. He never complained. But what was problematic for him? the violence over there in slum area. His landlady, now I'm telling you why he hated the atmosphere. His landlady, where he was residing, she had, you know, she used to beat her children regularly. And daily he would hear loud noises, children shrieking and shouting, and lady beating them up. And every Saturday her husband came drunk and beat her. So slum area, they are residing in a circumstances, wife is being beaten up by husband and frustrated wife beating all the children further. This is, you know, hierarchy of actions. The kind of actions we receive, we, you know, try to channelize those on our kids also. The kind of behavior is done to us. Two things are there. When you are being treated good, you will treat others good. Sometimes we are mistreated by others. And we also start mistreating others, the people we meet, siblings, parents, kids. Or we also make sure ki nahi, agar mere saath bura hua hai, I will not let others make feel the same. So it's up to us how we want to. So she was being beaten up by her husband. She was beating her children. Lot of noise, fightings, yelling. Aise atmosphere mein ek bachcha kaise pad sakta hai? That was a regular scene at the lodgings where he was residing. Clear? Now you know how he has survived. Fine? Now, they are not all okay. But at least you have a room of your own, which is more than I can say, said Yuri when he called round in the evening. Yuri is his friend. He's also a scientist. You might have heard about him. He invented. Yuri has also made n number of inventions. You will read. Yes, Ramanjit is having idea. Astronaut. You read about him. Inventions. Full name? Yes, Yuri Gagarin. So you will read about what achievements he had made in life. Fine. So Yuri suggested to him that at least you have a room, which is more than I can say. At least you live among civilized human beings, even if they are all poor students, said Albert. Then uska friend usko samjhata, you know, friends are there to always help you or make you, motivate you. So friend kehta, so what if you are having problem? At least you have a room to reside. Aise bachche bhi jinke paas room nahi hoga, then so you should be happy with what you have. But he says, आगे से क्या कहते हैं अल्बर्ट, ही सेज एट लीस्ट यूरी यू आर लिविंग अमंग सिविलाइज्ड पीपल, बट आई एम लिविंग विद द पीपल हु आर नॉट एट ऑल सिविलाइज्ड, हु डू नॉट हैव मैनर्स, हु कीप ऑन बुलिंग ईच अदर, कीप ऑन फाइटिंग, एंड लैंडलेडी कीप ऑन बीटिंग द चिल्ड्रन. सो दिस इज द सीन. यूरी सेज द वे द प्लेस वेयर आई रिजाइड दे आर ऑल नॉट ऑल सिविलाइज्ड. डिड यू नॉट हियर दैट वन ऑफ देम वाज किल्ड लास्ट वीक इन अ ड्यूएल. So Yuri अपनी जगह की एग्जाम्पल दे रहे हैं, that where I reside, that is also not that good. Yes, mix of people are living there, but the problem is last week only one person was killed by the other. तो मैं तो ऐसी जगह पे रहता हूँ जहाँ पे मर्डर हो रहे हैं. You are much better than me. So friend is trying to console one of the other friend. Clear? And what happens to the one who killed him? Nothing, of course. He's even proud of it. He's saying, I reside at a place where murderers are proud of themselves that they're killing others. He's even proud of it. His only worry is that authorities have told him not to fight any more duels. He's upset about this because he has not a single scar on his face to wear for the rest of his life as a badge of honor. Samajh mein aayi baat? Let me make you understand. Online children, keep on sending me your consent that you are there. He's saying that the place, Yuri is giving example of his lodgings. He's saying where I am residing, last week there was a scuffle, there was a duel or fight in which one man killed the other. And nothing was done, no action was taken against the murderer. And murderer is sad. Why he is sad? Because he is asked not to repeat his actions again. Number one. Number two, he does not have any scar on his face. as a mark of his winning in the that duel. So means such kind of place, Yuri saying, I'm living at that place, jahan pe koi maar ke chala jata hai kisi ko. And they are so proud of their achievement that yes, I have killed someone and I should be proud of it. Wo keh rahe tere yahan pe to sirf ladai ho rahi hai. And the place where I am residing, there are murders are happening. So they are both friends are discussing with one another the situations of their particular lodgings. Is it clear? Any doubts so far to anyone? All clear? Yes, clear. Last boy, clear. Idhar sabko, online children also, if you have any problem, you can type in the chat box. Next then, we'll continue tomorrow. Well, okay.